Over the course of the three CPD workshops, we're going to talk you through the Curious Minds ESERO framework for inquiry. This is going to help you with planning your teaching of STEM activities in your school. We're now going to talk you through it step by step.
The Curious Minds ESERO framework for inquiry has been developed by Curious Minds facilitators and teachers working with science education specialists, and is designed to be used in the planning and teaching of a topic or theme on the SESE science curriculum. The Curious Minds ESERO framework for inquiry is designed to bring you through the inquiry-based teaching and learning process as you plan and teach a particular topic or theme. Use these following 10 steps to help you. Number 1. Once you've decided on the topic or theme, write down the curriculum strand, strand unit, learning objectives, and skill development that you intend to address. Use the curriculum links and learning objectives and the tables in the planning guide to find the Curious Minds activities that best suit your requirements. You can download the required activity from curiousminds.ie. Number 2. Consider how you will engage your learners. How will you introduce the new experience to the children?
By using a prompt,
such as a picture, video, story, or show and tell object. This should be something that will stimulate discussion. Number 3. The discussion should lead to wondering. This could be posing a problem, providing a scenario, or to draw a mind map to come up with possible solutions. Number 4. Exploring. Encourage the children to consider various options and to compare the alternatives that they develop. Number 5. You present the problem to be investigated by posing a starter question for investigation. This could also come from the children themselves. Number 6. Consider how the children will predict and provide reasons for their predictions. It is important that they record their predictions in some way so they can compare these to their findings. Number 7. When it comes to conducting the investigation, consider how you organize the children to design, plan, and conduct the inquiry-based activity. Consider also what makes it a fair test. This needs to include how they will collect and organize their data. Number 8. Plan for sharing or interpreting the data and results. How you will get the children to share what they have found, what the data is telling them, and how they use their results to draw conclusions. Number 9. Consider how to extend their new understanding and skills by applying learning to a new scenario or problem, making connections with the world around them or with other curriculum areas, or thoughtful actions on helping make their own environment a better place, based on what they have learned. Number 10. Reflection. It is important for you to reflect back by asking yourself some key questions on what you have achieved, or what could have been done better next time. If possible, provide opportunities for the children to reflect on their own learning. You can use the blank Curious Minds ESERO framework for inquiry to plan your topic or theme. The filled-in example framework for inquiry provides some pointers for each of the steps outlined above.
Now that you've been introduced to the Curious Minds ESERO framework, you can see how useful a tool it can be for the classroom. I like that it helps me organize my thoughts and get things down on paper. One of the big things I find is that when I'm teaching, I have great ideas and then I can't remember it the next time I go around to do the subject. By breaking it down into the different areas I want to approach and thinking about the inclusions for my class, I'm able to keep a record for future teaching. And most importantly, it has a space for reflections at the bottom. So if something goes wrong, I can learn from it in future. This isn't supposed to be extra work though. It's something to help you feel more comfortable and more confident so everyone can get involved and enjoy science. Good luck and have fun.